To create your personal My Social Security account with an ID.me account, go to ssa.gov and select Sign In. On the Sign In or Create an Account screen, select Create an Account with ID.me. Select OK to leave Social Security's website. You will be redirected to the ID.me identity verification process. Enter your personal email address, then create a strong ID.me password that meets the following requirements. Your password must be a minimum of 8 characters long, include at least one uppercase letter and one lowercase letter, and include at least one number. Avoid including these things in your password. Common phrases or repeated characters like ABC or 111, personal dates like your birth date, parts of your email address, and parts of passwords that you use for other accounts like your bank account or email account. Select I accept the ID.me Terms of Service and Privacy Policy. Select Create Account. Next, check for an email from ID.me at the email address you provided. Open the email and select Confirm Your Email. You'll be redirected to the ID.me website. If you can't select the button in the email, you can enter the 6-digit code from the email on the ID.me website and select Confirm Code. Now that you've created a strong password to protect your account, let's set up your multi-factor authentication, commonly referred to as MFA. MFA is an extra layer of security that helps us make sure that it's you accessing your account and not someone pretending to be you. You can choose from several MFA methods, including a recovery code. We encourage you to choose at least 2 methods. If you choose to use text message or phone call, you will receive a warning that it is a less secure method, but you can select continue anyway to continue. Once you successfully add your MFA method of choice, your ID.me account creation is complete. Select Continue. The next step is to verify your identity for your ID.me account. This helps us protect your identity and prevent scammers from unauthorized access to your information. You will need to upload photos of the front and back of your driver's license, state ID, passport, or passport card. You can take these photos during the process, but it's often easier to take photos ahead of time and save them on your phone or your computer. It's important to get a full, clear image. Here are some tips for taking photos. Make sure your ID, especially the barcode, is clean and undamaged. Prop your ID up against a solid, dark background. Turn off your camera's flash and live photo functions. Make sure there are no glares or shadows and that you're capturing the entire ID. Hold your phone as still as you can while you take the photos. Try to hold your breath for the moment you take each photo. There are resources available to help you if you live outside of the US or if you do not have a Social Security number and are creating an ID.me account. Visit these help pages for assistance with verifying your identity. If you live outside of the US and have an SSN, if you are using an individual taxpayer identification number, ITIN, or a non-US passport. These pages include information on what you'll need to verify your identity, how to get started, the necessary steps to complete your enrollment, and help troubleshooting problems. Follow the prompts on the screen to select the identity document you'll be using. You can verify your identity with a video call or by uploading photos of your ID using your phone. In this tutorial, we'll continue as if you chose, upload photos of your license or state ID. Before you begin the process, review the consent terms. These terms allow ID.me to collect personal information like your photo, your biometrics used for face and fingerprint unlock, and your Social Security number to confirm your identity. Check the box if you agree to the ID.me terms and then select Continue. Enter your mobile phone number and select Continue. If you started this process on the computer, that's okay. We will continue the next few steps on your phone. Open the text message received from ID.me and select the link. This will open a new browser. Confirm your email address on file by selecting Yes. After you confirm your email address, follow the prompts on the screen to start your document upload. The next several steps vary based on the type of ID selected. In this video, we'll use a driver's license to demonstrate. Select Start Document Upload to continue. Select Take Photo of your driver's license or state ID front. You can decide to upload your ID from your image gallery or take the photo now. Repeat this process for the back of your ID. Select Continue when you are ready to proceed. Now, you must take a selfie. Select I am ready to take a selfie when you are ready to continue. After you've submitted the required photos, ID.me will take a moment to process your images. If your document upload fails, read the ID.me troubleshooting tips and try again. Or you can choose to verify your identity over a video call with a trusted ID.me agent. Visit these help pages for more information about verifying your identity with an extended video call or a short video call. These resources include information about what you'll need, how to get started, the necessary actions to verify your identity, and a troubleshooting guide. Once you've successfully submitted your identity documentation, the screen will prompt you to return to the other open browser tab to continue. Enter your Social Security number when prompted. Review your details and make sure they are correct. Select the checkbox for the Fair Credit Reporting Act, or FCRA, and select Yes. Next, you will need to authorize ID.me to share your verified information with SSA. Select Allow, and ID.me should redirect you back to SSA.gov. If you're not redirected or an error message displays on your screen, don't worry. Simply open a new tab. Once you read the SSA Terms of Service and Privacy Policy, select Next to continue. Congratulations! You now have access to your Social Security account information.